Hello students, you are welcome to your own YouTube channel Easy Science for All. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about oxidation reaction and oxidizing agent. But before that, here is an important message for you. When you subscribe our YouTube channel, it motivates us to come up with more new informative videos. Let us now see what does an oxidation reaction means. These are the five different criteria on the basis of which we can define or categorize any reaction as an oxidation reaction. If during a chemical reaction, addition of oxygen to a reactant takes place, then we can call such a chemical reaction as an oxidation reaction. Or if during a chemical reaction, there is removal of hydrogen from a reactant, then also we can call such a reaction as an oxidation reaction. The other three criteria for categorizing a chemical reaction as an oxidation reaction are as follows. Loss of electron by an atom or species of a reactant, or addition of electronegative element to a reactant, or removal of electropositive element from a reactant. If we see any of these characteristics during a chemical reaction, then we can call that reaction as an oxidation reaction. Now we will try to understand first three characteristic features with the help of some examples. While remaining two, you will be studying in your senior classes. Here are few examples relating to your first criteria, and these are as follows. In this first reaction of burning of coal, there are two reactants, carbon and oxygen, and on reaction, oxygen is getting added to carbon. So it means that oxidation of carbon has taken place in this reaction. Or in other words, we can say that carbon has been oxidized in this reaction. Likewise, in this second reaction pertaining to formation of water, there are two reactants, hydrogen and oxygen, and after the reaction, oxygen is getting added to hydrogen. This means that as per the definition, oxidation of hydrogen is taking place. Or in other words, we can say that hydrogen has been oxidized in this reaction. Likewise, in this third reaction of burning of magnesium ribbon, magnesium is getting oxidized during the reaction because on reacting with oxygen, oxygen is getting added to magnesium. So we can call it as oxidation of magnesium. Likewise, in this reaction, oxidation of copper is taking place. In this reaction, oxidation of carbon is taking place. In this reaction, oxidation of sulfur is taking place. In this reaction, oxidation of methane gas is taking place. And in this reaction, oxidation of hydrogen chloride is taking place. It is because in all these reactions, oxygen is getting added to the encircled reactants. So, going by the criteria, all of these reactants have been oxidized in these respective reactions. Now, let us discuss the second criteria for oxidation, that is removal of hydrogen from a reactant. Let us see some examples pertaining to this criteria. Here we have taken two examples pertaining to the criteria of removal of hydrogen. In this first reaction, you can see that there are two reactants, namely hydrogen sulfide and oxygen. On reaction with oxygen, in this reaction, hydrogen sulfide is getting converted to sulfur, that is removal of hydrogen is taking place from the hydrogen sulfide. So going by this criteria, we can say that hydrogen sulfide has been oxidized to sulfur in this case. Or in other words, we can say that oxidation of hydrogen sulfide has taken place in this reaction. Likewise, in this second reaction of burning of natural gas, you can see that there are two reactants, namely methane and the second one is oxygen. On reacting with oxygen, methane is getting converted to carbon dioxide, that is, hydrogen atoms are getting removed from the methane molecule. So we can say that methane has been oxidized in this case, or in other words, we can say that oxidation of methane, that is CH4, has taken place in this reaction. Let us now discuss the third criteria of oxidation, that is loss of electron by an atom of a reactant. As you can see in this reaction, there are two reactants, namely sodium and chlorine. Sodium is a metal, whereas chlorine is a non-metal. When they are reacting with each other, then it is resulting in the formation of an ionic compound, namely sodium chloride. This is sodium chloride. During this reaction, two atoms of sodium metal are losing two electrons, and these two electrons are being gained by two atoms of chlorine. So going by this third criteria or third definition of oxidation, we can say that since sodium metal has lost electron in this reaction, so sodium has been oxidized, or oxidation of sodium atom has taken place in this reaction. In this reaction, as well as the reactions given on the previous slides, you will agree that one reactant is getting oxidized. But did you ever thought who is helping them out in getting oxidized? It is the oxidizing agent who is helping them out in getting oxidized. So the next question that comes to mind is, what is an oxidizing agent? An oxidizing agent is a reactant which gives up oxygen during a chemical reaction, or which accepts hydrogen during a chemical reaction, or which accepts electrons during a chemical reaction. But it is for sure that it is a reactant. Let us try to understand this with the help of following two examples. In the first reaction, reactant oxygen is getting converted to water. So it means that it is accepting hydrogen from the other reactant, that is methane. So we can say that in this case, oxygen is the oxidizing agent. In the second example, there are two reactants, zinc oxide and carbon. And out of these two reactants, zinc oxide is giving away its oxygen and getting converted to zinc. So it means that in this case, or in this reaction, zinc oxide is behaving like an oxidizing agent, or it is the oxidizing agent in this case. The first criteria. Likewise, in this third reaction, chlorine and sodium are the two reactants, and out of these two reactants, chlorine is accepting electrons from sodium. So it means that going by this third criteria, chlorine is oxidizing agent in this case. We can summarize all this information in the form of a table like this. That's it for now. If you have any query regarding this lecture, you can comment to us, and Don't forget to click on subscribe button. Thank you.